Hey guys, it's Will. So the quantum computing market is one of the fastest growing technology markets in 2025. And we've seen them get some momentum ahead of 2026. In fact, we were trading data center markets today. We were up about $56 on this position over here on TSSI as they've continued to potentially find a support here. And we picked up about 300 shares there earlier today in our market live session. If you ever want to tune in, it's the second link down below for the daily live trading. Now, data center markets are pretty interesting because when you look at the NVQ link, which was recently announced from Nvidia, it is this quantum computer integration and connecting quantum computers and GPU computing for 17 quantum builders and 9 scientific labs. So essentially, you know, the top market that most investors have been watching in the development of AI was GPUs. That includes Nvidia, that includes Broadcom, you're looking at Taiwan Semiconductor, AMD, ON Semiconductor, and many others. And in that process of the GPU market for AI, then you have another connection to the GPUs, which is the quantum computers that was recently announced from Nvidia in the partnership with these top companies. The companies include IonQ, Dirac, Atom Computing, Rigetti Computing, Orca Computing, IQM, Quantum Machines, QEra, and many others, Silicon Quantum Computing. When you're looking at this article here, you might say, okay, well, that's cool, but what does that mean for investors, and why does quantum computing currently have a bullish or bearish sentiment? Well, when we're looking at the market in general over the last year, you're looking at a very bullish sentiment in the quantum market. Some of our top positions this year, including Rigetti, QBTS, and others, have been driven by over 100% gains. When we look at IonQ, for example, you could take a look at their very consistent uptrend from around $6 a share up into now around $60 a share. They've had this very consistent uptrend with the exception of some pullbacks earlier this year. Every quantum company has a similar chart to this. This uptrend, this surge, using previous resistance as support, and then now bouncing that 200-day moving average. So a lot of times this green line here is going to act as a support in a bullish environment. And in the smaller trends, the blue line, the EMA, is going to act as a support or resistance in bearish trends. Now, currently, we just saw IonQ and a lot of quantum companies have a pretty good day today. They were up pretty good. Rigetti was up to $30 a share. You got IonQ was up to $55 a share or more, and then QBTS was up there as well to some levels that are worth noting. Looks like they were at $28 or $29 a share. And so as they're bouncing the 200-day moving average, three things are really happening that are from the technical perspective. Now we look at the markets, we look at the news, the financials, and the technicals. But just in the technical perspective, you could see that they bounce the 200-day moving average, which is oftentimes indication of further uptrends. You can see that they pushed above the EMA, which is oftentimes signaling what could be a reversal or now a continuation in a trend going up. And the RSI, the MACD, you can see the MACD crossed over. This is on the one-day time frame, looking back, indicating that potentially we're seeing this continuation back up. Now, the current levels that they're at are a previous resistance here that they saw back in January of 2025, and you can see that level there. And, you know, this actually applies to almost every quantum company. If you pull up QBTS, you kind of see a similar scenario where they just bounce a 200-day moving average, and they're also pushed up above that EMA. You can see that there, and they're at a previous resistance, maybe not that they saw back in January, but that they saw back here in September of this year. You see that level there. So most quantum companies have seen some nice recoveries and continue to now make some runs back up into previous highs, or at least that seems to be the next target. And what does that mean for investors right now? Well, again, market long term looks excellent. You do see a lot of growth in the D-Wave sector. From a perspective of capital, they've gained capital in their balance sheet by up to $865 million. And IonQ has had a similar run. They've jumped in capital up here to about, see, their total cash is up to now $4 billion in their balance sheet. And then Rigetti stock, they've jumped up as well. They're holding a pretty good amount of cash as well. And so while we're looking at the market cap, the market caps are still pretty high, $19 billion for IonQ. You see QBTS is up there as well. They're holding around $10 billion. And so these market caps are currently pretty high compared to how much cash they have, even though they're getting a substantial amount of cash. It's not a small amount of cash, $1 billion. Maybe by some people's estimates, but I think no, even by the billionaires' estimates, $1 billion is a lot of cash. But on top of that, you have some recent deals that a lot of them have seen and anticipations of further integrations with Nvidia, which is a big announcement with this NVQ link. But the problem is that a lot of them are still not having revenue. So that's why currently, if you look at the quantum markets, you're still buying what could be in the current market. Because while IonQ's got a lot of cash, they got that very consistent uptrend, and most of these companies do. You can see that on IonQ here, very consistent uptrend. And while personally, I've been an investor over the last year, and we've been covering them since around this time last year, actually, if not a little bit before, and they've been great performing assets for us, there's still the concern that the current revenues haven't showed up. In fact, if you look at the last quarter for IonQ, they came in with negative $1 billion with revenue at just $39 million. So the revenue is still drastically lower than you would expect from a company valued at $20 billion. And so while you can buy what could be, and that's what investors have done, and that's why quantum computing has done so well. But if you really get on the inside of the conversation and look at the commercial applications and how much money they're generating from the commercial deployments, it's very minimal. In fact, $39 million is still very small, and their net income is massively negative at $1 billion loss in the quarter. I mean, at that rate, if they've got $4 billion in assets and total equities at $2 billion, shoot, they only have two more quarters that they can live through. So the problem is that their current cash burn is so high that when you're looking at these valuations right now, you got to get a little bit skeptical and say, okay, it looks perfect in this trend. All right here at this breakout moment where we could see them continue up. And hey, that could happen. And for our long-term positions, to get there earlier, great. But last time when we saw things push up to $84 here, or you know, 50 something dollars on Rigetti and what have you, we actually shorted the market so that we wouldn't lose so much on our longer term positions. And it was actually a perfect trade towards the end of the year to actually short some of the quantum companies to see the recoveries. So if I'm not giving you more confidence about this medium term and what the targets are, I'm sorry. We just don't have the answers for why they would continue to bull up other than sentiment. Then there's no other reasons why. There's not any supporting massive outlier in the revenues. There's not any outliers, even really in the cash. And in fact, a lot of the market caps still seem overvalued at the current prices. So when you look at it, you look at people buying into the future. And when I went to a conference recently, you know, we went to a few conferences this year, CES for quantum. We went to the D-Wave Qubits conference. And then we also went to the Albuquerque quantum computing conference. And in two of those, we were able to meet CEOs and executives from these companies, including Rigetti and QBTS and IonQ. And general consensus from a lot of the companies when I talked to them while they're doing some amazing things from scrubbing CO2 from the air and building, batteries that are more efficient, or Rigetti building superconducting computers that are getting their error rate down to, record levels and allowing themselves to integrate the QPU with, for example, Microsoft's Majorana chip. It looks like it's going to be a perfect fit for Microsoft there with their quantum computer. While those things are all great, every person that I talked to at the conferences I recently went to basically told me that quantum is still many years away from the full commercial applications. Now, I wanted to test that. I wanted to know. And so that's why inside of the Prophecy app, for example, if you log in and we're in our app here, which we've developed over the last about 6 months here, you could search a stock, right? And so we could search any stock. Let's go ahead and we could jump in with Microsoft here. And what we do is we get, the best AI models to do the analysis. But what we recently added, well, you got a future chart, you got technical analysis, AI fundamental analysis, the support, the resistance, the insider buying and selling, all these things. And you could select your AI model and choose which one you want to do the analysis for you. You can have different pages, and then you can look at the next month, the next 6 months, the next year, and look at what those projections look like. Right now, it's only loaded on the 1 month. What we've recently added is the ability for you to utilize the same backend and technology that's used over at IonQ and Rigetti. So we're actually working on integrating quantum, and we're not there with D-Wave, a quantum analysis into the actual analysis of the time frames. So for example, on Microsoft here, we got the next hour here, or the next 4 hour, next 1 hour that looks negative for Microsoft Corporation. But then the next 6 months might look bullish for Microsoft of about 9%. And each one of these time frames in their projections has a confidence score that's provided to us from the AI. In this case, it's Grok. And so what we've done is we've said, okay, take the AI confidence scores from all of these. And what we do is we put it into Rigetti or IonQ quantum analysis, and we use some algorithms like density matrix or the Hamiltonian. And then the result is a quantum enhanced confidence score. So it takes all of other confidence scores and then gives us which confidence score is most likely accurate according to quantum. And so you just go through, we click this button up here, it drops it down, and then essentially it gives us the quantum analysis. And so if I add the quantum analysis widget here, we haven't run any quantum analysis just yet. Why don't I open a whole new page for this actually? Quantum analysis. So why am I showing you this? It's because I thought that nobody could use quantum computers. But we went through testing and we actually ran some shots on Rigetti, and then found that certain reservations for IonQ were around $1,000 or $5,000 per hour. We thought, wow, that's quite some investment in order to run quantum. It's pretty expensive, and so the commercial application is actually very expensive. And so right now, it makes sense that most companies will not run quantum analysis unless they develop a local model that uses the quantum properties and the simulation of IonQ or Rigetti. And so that's exactly what we developed here at the Prophecy app. And so now, again, I can click on IonQ. Let's see if it goes through. There we go. So the most confident time frame, according to this Microsoft, is according to IonQ, the most confident time frame is the next 6 months. And so we can actually run this analysis on, for example, Rigetti. Let's run RGTI. Okay, RGTI. And let's get some analysis going here. So as you can see, 6 months, 64 shots used, confidence score that Microsoft will go up by 8% in the next 6 months was a confidence score of about 81%. Now, we got Rigetti Computing pulled up here, so I can click next month or what have you, and I can go through and do a quantum analysis as soon as all of the analysis has loaded up. So just take a second, and as soon as it's loaded, we'll be good to go. There we are. So I'm gonna click here, and I'm gonna use Rigetti quantum analysis on Rigetti stock. See what we come out with. Looks like the next 6 months is the confidence score of 76%. Anticipating Rigetti is gonna hold above $36 a share and increase by 28%. So again, big investments from Nvidia. When we're looking at some of the insiders, for example, you can see BlackRock is investing. Nvidia is a company that's looking at this company investing. Vanguard is investing, and more buys than sells. So while they might be far away, ultimately the targets are fairly bullish and the confidence is fairly bullish as well. And we could do the same for IonQ, and we can get the quantum analysis for IonQ as well. So we'll have to wait for the full loading of it. But again, when you're looking at IonQ and you look at the insiders, they got Vanguard buying, BlackRock, Geode Capital, State Street, who have all purchased, and they've got more buys than sells, about 15 buys to 5 sells. On the insider side of things, you could see the CEO has been making some transactions along with some the CRO and the COO, and they've had more purchases than sales on the insider side. So let's go ahead, let's run the quantum analysis. So again, you can look at the next year for IonQ is also anticipated to grow by about 50%, quite a bullish outlook. And let's run IonQ on IonQ. Let's see what we got. There we are. So looks like the most confident time frame for IonQ, according to IonQ, is the next week, in that we see a sell down, continued sell down. And I think that Rigetti had a similar outlook in that they were looking to sell down here in the near term. We can get a look here. Let's see how that looks over the next day. Yep. Anticipating more sell down. So again, volatility in the near term. Definitely some volatility in the near term, and then over the longer period timeframes, a little bit more certain on the bullishness as these markets continue to get more investments and innovate faster. So that's kind of the general consensus, and you can see that very similar for most quantum companies. I hope this has been helpful for you. Again, we're going to continue to hold our long-term positions and even look for shorter-term trades when we see these breakouts kick in, like we were trading last week with APLX. And this morning with data center stocks, if you ever want to tune on in to join in on those investments, I would love to have you there. In StockMates, you get to see my entries, see my exits, and surround yourself with like-minded individuals. We have our weekly targets, and we have a live session Monday through Friday, market open. Would love to see you there as soon as tomorrow. Again, it's the second link in the description to join StockMates. Appreciate you all. Again, if I earned your thumbs up, hit the like button. Do consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.